the political news cycle is fast, and keeping up can be overwhelming. Trying to find differing perspectives worth your time is even harder. That's why we have scoured the internet for political writing from the right and left that you might not have seen. Has this series exposed you to new ideas? Tell us how. Email us at ourpicks@netimes.com. For an archive of all the partisan writing roundups, check out our picks. From the right, Secretary of State Rex W. Tillerson with President Trump last month at a meeting with Malaysia's leader. Doug Mills, The New York Times, Kevin D. Williamson in National Review. See this for Donald Trump. He has been successful at one thing, bringing American politics down to his level. It's asinine, childish and emotionally incontinent, but that is where he is comfortable. One recalls the proverbial advice about wrestling a pig: you both get dirty, but the pig likes it. Mr. Williamson is concerned about reports that Nick Ayers, the chief of staff to Vice President Mike Pence, suggested that the Republicans conduct a purge of those in the party who may not fully support President Trump's agenda. In Mr. Williamson's view, Republicans have not rallied behind the Trump agenda because there isn't anything to rally behind. And the Trump movement, he writes, is turning into a nervous breakdown inside the Republican Party. Read more, David Bossy in the Hild coalition of anti-Washington voters around the country has taken notice. Judge Roy Moore's victory in the recent U.S. Senate runoff election in Alabama is evidence that even with the election of President Trump, the Washington establishment continues with more business as usual. Mr. Bossy, the president of the conservative lobbying group Citizens United, thinks that any fissures within the governing party begin with the fact that Republican leaders in Congress continued to kick the can down the road on government spending and refused to stand up to the dangerous Obama agenda. Policy is paramount, he argues, and since the Republican-controlled Congress to date has not gotten the job done, he warns that maybe as primary season approaches, voters will once again send them a message. Read more, Jennifer Rubin in the Washington Post. The unpleasant reality for Trump, of course, is that having neglected or attacked his own party, he may find many of its members replaced by hostile Democrats who will seek to remove him. That is certainly reason for Republican pessimism. The damage is clear. According to Ms. Rubin, Trump may have successfully demonized his own party within the GOP to the point that it may be hard to return Republican majorities to Congress in the midterm elections next year. Ms. Rubin blames congressional leaders for a paucity of policy ideas and excessive infighting as well. Read more, from the left. Mr. Trump and Melania Trump, the First Lady, board Air Force One on their way to Las Vegas on Wednesday. Doug Mills, The New York Times. Zach Beauchamp in Vox Public. Clashes between the president and top aides can literally undercut the administration's foreign policy goals. This past weekend, for example, Tillerson said that he was negotiating directly with North Korean officials, but then Trump tweeted that he should knock it off. The mixed signal between Mr. Trump and Secretary of State Rex W. Tillerson makes it hard for the North Koreans to figure out what the U.S. government wants from them, Mr. Beauchamp explains. It also has a more pernicious effect on the administration's ability to carry out its business. The fact that Trump's rough management style has been publicly reported makes all of this worse. It makes it hard to fill vital open positions. Read more, GOP here in the New Republic. A more style GOP can remain an electoral force in the same way that the current GOP does, with a combination of gerrymandering, voter suppression, and the Senate and Electoral College's overrepresentation of small, rural, overwhelmingly white states, their bias toward conservative voters. In other words, Mr. Moore's recent victory in the Alabama Republican Senate primary leads Mr. Heer to conclude that the party is actually in much stronger shape than others appear to believe. While such a Republican Party eventually might have a harder time winning national elections, he argues, it can do well enough in Congress to block Democratic legislation. Ultimately, these moments give parties more energy by riling up the base. Read more, Robert Schlesinger in U.S. Newsway. Interrupt your stunned disbelief about the tragedies visited upon the nation in Puerto Rico and Las Vegas for a periodic reminder that things are as preposterously dysfunctional as you think they are in Republican-run Washington, D.C. Mr. Schlesinger connects the recent controversies surrounding Mr. Tillerson and Mr. Ayers to earlier ones in the Trump administration, concluding that the White House has a well-earned reputation as a tumultuous freak show of instability. The problems have extended to the fraying relationship between the Hill and the administration, he argues. And he views the relationship as in decline if not in doubt disintegration. Read more, __, and finally, from the center Albert R. Hunt and Bloomberg Tillerson tried, but his effort proved to be futile. Trump ignored his chief diplomat, allowing him to be undercut by his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, who has no foreign policy experience. Mr. Hunt is blunt in his view of the state of the Tillerson-Trump marriage as a result of his rift with Trump. Tillerson has limited credibility with foreign leaders. Mr. Hunt notes that history is unkind to these kind of partnerships and that the history of CEOs moving to top cabinet posts is mixed at best. Read more, __, want the partisan writing roundup in your inbox? Sign up for the Morning Briefing newsletter or the What We're Reading newsletter. Have thoughts about this collection? Email feedback to ourpics@netimes.com.